Welcome to numerical methods. Now we are going to discuss one of the example in implementing bisection method, one of the implementation of intermediate theorem. Okay, so we take a function yx equals to x power of 6 minus x minus 1. And you are required to find the stable condition or zero value on that function in the range of 1 and 2 by using bisection method, and then you have to continue your iteration until 0.005 of the error, and after that you need to verify that your result is correct or very close to the exact solution. Okay, let's get started. The first thing that you have to do is you prepare a table number A, C, B, F, A, F, C, F, B, and error. So number here, 0 means the initial value. So because you are already required to find in between 1 and 2, then you have to follow 1 and 2. But if you are not required and you are free to use any numbers, then you can use any numbers, but you have to make sure that the multiplication of the two values are negative value. Okay, let's get started. So first, the first value is 1 and the second value is B, and in between will be C. So because you are required in the range of 1 and 2, it means A equals to 1, B equals to 2. Then you start calculating FA, FB. Okay, you calculate FA and you have the results minus 1. Then use 2 and put it into the function. Then you have the value of 61. Okay, have a look. FA minus 1. FB 61, so it means 1 is negative, now another 1 is positive, either way, as long as the multiplication of 2 will be negative, then you will be happy, it means A and B is okay, and then you can continue. If the value of the function are the same sign, means minus minus or positive positive, then you cannot use, you cannot continue, then you have to find another value. Once you have this, so it means the result will be in between, then you calculate in between 1 and 2 is 1.5. okay, then calculate 1.5 in the function, so put the value 1.5 to the function, and then you have this value. Okay, now you have three values, negative, positive, positive. And remember, the range should be the function value, one is negative, another one is positive. So in that case, the values that you are going to use is A and C, because negative and positive. You cannot use B and C because positive and positive. So A and C, those two are different signs. So that should be okay. Okay, then what you have to do, 1.5 assume as B, A assume as 1 assume as A. Then you can continue. Okay, that's what you have to do. Now, you have to calculate the error first, because you are using A and C, so the difference between A and C is 1 minus 1.5, 0.5 absolute value. Then you can continue the second iteration. So copy 1 here, copy 1.5 to B. Okay, now this is the second iteration. So you have 1.5. Then calculate again. This already calculated 1.5 already calculated. Just copy from the middle cell to another cell. Okay, and then what is the middle value of 1.5? Then you can calculate 1.25. Then again, calculate the function of 1.25, and then you can find 1.564697. Okay, let's have a look. So now, which one of the value that you can use? A, B, C. With A, B, C, then you can select the two values, which is 1 and 1.5, because these two give you different signs of the function. Then you can use that. Okay, and then calculate the error, 1 minus 1.25, the absolute value is 0.25. Okay, then you can continue. The same, then finally, after 10 iteration, you have the error 0.00048, which is okay, and that's under the criteria, which is 0.0005. So what is the results then? The result is 1.34277. If you calculate this, the result will be very close to zero. Okay, that is the result. So if you plot, this is the result. 1.034277. This is your point. Okay, thank you very much.